Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, and I host the Valder Beebe Show on FM radio and internet television. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, which I conduct by cell phone, in studio, or satellite media tours. Go to ValderBeebeShow.com, YouTube.com/ValderBeebeShow, or our partnership network with Business in the Black, which is BlackSuccessAcademy.com. And click on the Valder Beebe Show channel. I'll see you there.
Thank you for joining us today, Colleen Burns, at the beginning and the start of a week. And they call you the mom on the run, and you got some back to school dash information for my audience today.
I do, Valder. You know, the National Retail Federation says this is the second biggest back to school shopping season we've ever had. $80 billion will be spent. 60% of us are going to buy electronics. A lot of that is tablets and laptops as young as the middle school age now, because that's when kids are getting their tablets and laptops. And your back to school expenses might also include orthodontia, because 7 of 10 kids need their teeth straightened. It's so important for their self-esteem, but some kids can be self-conscious about those traditional metal braces. And you might not know that it's comparable in price to use Invisalign treatment. And it's 50% faster, the treatment now. So they're going to be a lot more comfortable. They're not going to have to deal with those metal brackets and wires, which can be especially harmful if they're in sports activities. Invisalign liners come right out when you're eating, so they don't have to avoid their favorite foods anymore. And you can still go to the movie theater and get popcorn.
Okay, that's good. So, you know, we always want to be with the in group. You know, you never want to be with the out group. So you got to get Invisalign, I'm telling you. You know, kids are cruel.
Oh, yes, they can be.
They can be. But I love it that you say it's comparable to metal braces. So I maybe we'll see a change.
I would think so. And, you know, I think kids are trying to be much more accepting and tolerant. Well, I think they always have been. I think we as parents can be bad influences on our children. I think they're very accepting and tolerant. But it's not necessarily what you're hearing from your peers. It's sometimes just how self-conscious you feel. Because if you stand out at all, as you know, during those formative years, it can be quite traumatic.
Okay, so we got them going back to school. Okay, what else do you think they need to compete? Because this is almost, being in a competitive environment.
It's true. And, you know, the competition part you're bringing up, that's a lot of times that's their own peers and the peer pressure that comes along with that. And children at this time of the year can be quite stressed out, not just the transition, but the peer pressure. So important to maintain open communication with your children on a regular basis, taking their temperature as far as their stress level and their anxiety. And also, even though drug testing might seem like a lot right now, it actually does offer an out for your child from what could be a really difficult situation. Because if your child is at a party and he or she is offered drugs and they don't know how to get out of that situation, they could easily say, I'm sorry, but my parents drug test me regularly. And then it's on you, it's not on them. Makes it a lot easier for them to get out of that situation. First Check is the leading at-home drug test, and this is so easy to get. You don't have to have a prescription. You just go to your local pharmacy, you buy one of these, and within 5 minutes, with 99% accuracy, you can determine if your child is taking any one of the 12 most commonly abused drugs, including 5 prescription drugs. And Valder, you know what an epidemic we have right now with the abuse of prescription drugs.
Yes, definitely. I wonder, how do you have that conversation?
Well, as I like to say, the conversations between parents and children are almost always not easy, but you have to have them. And it's much better to have them sooner than later.
Okay, and so does this help kids, you think, not fall prey to bad influences because they've got this ace in a hole?
Right, exactly. An easy way for them to get out of a difficult situation. And also talking about falling prey to bad influences, we should, you know, make sure that we pay attention to our actions and our words right now, because as you know, the nation's not in a great place, and a lot of parents are jumping on board, saying some kind of nasty things about somebody who doesn't agree with themselves. And in general, kids are compassionate by nature, they're tolerant by nature, so don't let them learn any bad habits from you.
Okay. Colleen Burns is my guest today, and as I told you, they call her Mom on the Run. She has a blog, and her greatest achievement, she's a mom of 6 boys.
That's so true.
You go, Colleen.
Thank you.
Okay, give me one more tip for my listening audience. Do you have one?
I do. So 44% of us, only 44% of us, are buying our back-to-school essentials online. And I think that's crazy, because you can so much more easily compare prices online. You can take your time, you can put things in a shopping cart, come back later. And I never, ever buy anything online without Googling promo code for whatever site I'm visiting, because you can almost always get a discount, and you can almost always get a discount if you subscribe to a mailing list from a site. You can always opt out later. But those are some quick, easy ways to save some money.
That's good. We always love to save money, Colleen. Is there a site online that my parents can put all of this together?
Absolutely. You can go to videopump.tv.
Colleen, you always have great information, so you're one of my most anticipated guests for my audience. Thank you for being on the Valder Beebe Show. I really appreciate it.
I always love being here. Thanks, Valder.